Wherever you go, I will keep you safe. Whatever's to happen to you, know that I am with you, and I will keep you safe. Does a groom allow any harm to come to his bride? You are my bride, and I am your groom. Yes, I'm coming soon, but until you see me, do not think I will not shelter and protect my bride. Does not my word say, though 1,000 fall by your side, though the dead surround you, I will keep you safe? Remember when the Israelites and the Egyptians were surrounded by darkness and light? Remember when the Egyptians had plagues and the Israelites had none? They lived side by side, did they not? Yet the Israelites were protected. So it was then, so it shall be again. Great horror, great horror, great horror will come to those that have flaunted my laws in my face, spit upon my Torah and defiled the holy word and ripped it to shreds. Great horror, great horror, great horror, great horror, great horror, great horror will come upon those that mock the word of Yahweh, that have been trashed and labeled as garbage. Great horror, great horror, great horror. You say I am a God of mercy and love, and when I speak rebuke or in harsh tones to my prophets, you say that is not my loving and merciful Father. Do I not say I chastise those I love? What parent disciplines their child without raising their voice? Foolish, foolish, foolish ones, I will slap you, I will strike you on the right and on the left, I will stomp on you, but for the sake of your souls I will allow Satan to kill the flesh. Because of my love and mercy, call upon me when that time comes, I will save your souls. Great whore, great whore, great whore, whore, great whore, great whore, great whore, such as this world has never seen. But listen, I give these words not for my bride, babies, chosen ones, and elect to fear. They are not for those who hear my voice and fear me. It is wisdom to fear the Lord. It is wisdom to try to be pure. It is wisdom to keep living holy and shun unholiness. You take the word of God and you hold it to the heathen's face and say, thus saith the Lord. Watch and see, your neighbor's house will be flattened. Plagues, sickness, death, and destruction and poverty will come. And watch how I cover those who are mine. I cover those who entered my Passover. Those who are mine who entered into my Passover. You will pass over the horror of my judgment to come. There is coming great devastation. The world will shake and quake in fear. Can the sun outshine my brilliance as I come closer to the earth? The lava will run. It cannot contain the anger of Yahweh anymore. But oh, you will see my angels encamp about those who love me. You need not fear. Those of you who hear my voice need not fear. When it is time to go, you will know. Did I not open the Red Sea? I did it then, so I shall do it again. Just as the evil Pharaoh and his troops chased my children of Israel, who just wanted to be free, to live holy and worship me. My children are the one I protected. Their enemies were destroyed. I did it then and I will do it again. The Israelites disobeyed and were delayed from entering the promised land by my chastisement. See the destruction come upon the whore of Babylon. Remember Hitler. As I have told my prophets, learn from Hitler, and you shall see what has been in the past shall be in the future. Oh, 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 rivers of blood shall flow. You so-called Christians with your mouths full of gold. It is gold sent from hell. Gold sent from hell. Gold sent from hell, you foolish, foolish. So Satan can take back what he has given you. Did not Hitler pull gold teeth out of the mouths of Jews? Satan mocks and laughs. As it was then, he will do it again. Those who know me know this is not of me. I'm commanding you to be humble. Why would I have you show off a mouthful of gold? Is this not pride? I despise the leaders who teach this and lead my people astray. You will know that you will know that you wicked spiritual leaders will stand before me one day and hear me say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity, I never knew you. Fall on your faces and repent. Get the gold ripped out of your mouths before Satan rips it out, for just as Hitler did, they shall come and do it again. The Antichrist shall come with extermination camps before he killed 6 million Jews. Now it will be 666 million Christians and Jews. Multitudes will be lukewarm in their faith, but before their life is taken, extinguished like a match flame, they will be on fire with love for Yahweh. What they do not have now, they will have then. Wouldn't it be easier now to sacrifice your mind, body, spirit, and soul, giving me your will, doing it my way, or would you rather wait to endure the horror that is to come? Do I not say in my word, the lukewarm I will spew out of my mouth? How can you think when reading my word that just anyone who labels themselves Christian will be caught up with me in the air? The bride I come for will be prepared, obedient and loyal, loving to me in all ways, mind, body, spirit, and soul, already dressed without spot or wrinkle. What bride makes her groom wait? It is the guest that lingers. The groom does not wait for his bride. The bride is ready when he appears. The extermination camps will not be full of my bride. None of my bride will be found there, but it will be full of guests. I have but one bride. When you are rounded up like herded cattle, pressed against one another where you can't move left or right, while you are still alive, the gold shall be ripped from your mouth. The gold shall be ripped from your mouth. The gold shall be ripped from your mouth and the jewelry from your body. That is what you get for following the false deceptions, great signs and wonders. I sent this prophet to warn you. Satan plays you. You are bait on the hook. Look and weep as spiritual leaders I once trusted dangle my people like bait on a hook over the jaws of hell. The evil spiritual leaders line their pockets with gold, as hell fills the people's mouths with gold, so the evil ones can rip it out like they did to the Jews. What you sow, you will reap. You and Israel, you follow this again. Have you not learned not to lust after gold so it can be ripped out of your mouth? Fall on your faces. Repent today. Flee from the leaders who lead you astray. For those who did not do a Passover Seder, not knowing what to do nor wanting to, learn now. You need a Passover for my judgment. I give you another chance because I am a God of mercy and love. I spoke to this prophet in a dream, so you can't say your God didn't warn you. I chastise those that I love. So it was then, so it shall be again. It is your choice. Do you want to be obedient now, or suffer my chastisement or my rejection later? So it was then, so it will be again.
Dear Yeshua, I accept you now as my Lord and my Savior. You are the God I love. I believe you paid the price for my sins at Calvary. You died and arose from the dead on the third day. I ask you to come into my heart, forgive me of my sins, wash me clean of all unrighteousness. I'm sorry I have sinned, and I turn away from those sins. Thank you for filling me with your Holy Spirit and giving me the desire to serve you all the days of my life and live your life in me, Yeshua, so you will be glorified. Thank you for giving me the desire to read your Bible and give me the wisdom to understand it. Thank you for loving me and saving my soul, causing my faith to grow so one day I will be with you in heaven. Fill me with your Holy Spirit now and deliver me from the evil one. In your name, Yeshua, I pray. Help me, Yeshua, to remember all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of Yahweh. And you came to save us sinners. That's why you're called our Savior. Amen.
please visit amightywind.com and almightywind.com and study the prophetic words that were given by God to Prophet Elizabeth Elijah.